Assalamu alaikum, I'm Dr. Bia Jamshed, and today I shall be covering MMIs, that are multiple mini interviews for Khan University's internship program. In case you've made it this far, congratulations. I will be giving you an overview of what my personal experience was while MMIs were conducted in 2023 for the batch of 2024. First off, it depends whether you are in your final year or you're already enrolled in some internship or house job program. If you are a final year medical student, you'll have to work a bit harder. But if you already are a house officer, then it would be much easier for you to get through this path. Starting off with the email, you will receive an email in which you have to reply and confirm your presence for the MMIs and submit your documents to them timely. I always suggest visiting that location of interviews a day or two prior. You'll meet other medical students there. You can ask them around whether they had their interviews taken, how were they, what stations they got, how did they prepare for it, how do you carry yourself. Do not preferably come in casual clothes. Come in an overall, have your stethoscope around your neck, just look professional so you can feel professional and perform professionally. The things you should carry along should include your phone, your roll number slips, a water bottle, a chocolate, and a mini deodorant bottle or a perfume along with you. So during my time, it was in the sports and rehabilitation center where the interviews were taken. They will divide you into certain batches. So once you are divided into batches, they will give you a chit which will have your name, your roll number, and your assigned number. So the number that is written on your chit will be your station to begin with. Next, you'd be asked to line up, and once you line up, this is the time, you know, things are about to get real. There's a big timer clock attached to the ceiling and you can always look up and see the time that's remaining. They give approx 2 to 3 minutes to every station, and I think that is more than enough. There are going to be a total of about 10 stations, so it will take you half an hour worth of time for the very interview. Have a little introduction prepared in which you will take 30 seconds to introduce yourself. It is very professional and very important to develop a rapport with the interviewer. You have to tell your name, your college, whether or not you're a medical student or an intern at some particular hospital, and your roll number that will help them trace it from the examiner's sheet. Once they have you traced, you can always begin. The key to reading a scenario and saving time is to read the last line of the entire scenario first, to know what you have to actually dig for in the above paragraph. Do not give impulsive answers. Take the time that you need to process your answer and only speak when you're confident enough. It is not practically possible for me to explain every single scenario to you, but I will share the crux of it. You need to know the hierarchy of a hospital, starting from a house officer, then a resident, then a consultant, then HOD, your paramedic staff, the helping staff, to the level of a janitor. How do you have to deal with patients? How do you have to deal with your colleague house officers, with your seniors? That is what all these interviews are about. The general idea is to always apologize in case you are doing something you're not supposed to do. Always involve your immediate senior and keep him in loop. For example, I got a station of triage. They will give you 4 individuals and 4 tasks and you have to mix and match. You will give the history taking to a final year medical student, record the CTG on your own. You'll give the normal vaginal delivery to the paramedic or the nursing staff because they are very experienced. And you'll give the C-section to a resident or a senior consultant. So that is how you'll have to manage your triage. So the interviews are not really based on, tell me something about yourself, or okay, perform this IV cannulation or catheterization. It's nothing of that sort. Always get the context and videos from Geeky Meds or YouTube videos generally on ethics. PLAB 2 videos on ethics. They're going to be very helpful in case you want to go very professional with it. So passing the test alone is not the end of the road. You really have to put active effort in the interviews to score well and save your spot. I would suggest you practicing the scenarios with your friends and in the mirror if you don't have any, because in my personal experience, I was the only one out of my entire college who made it this far and who got selected for AKU's internship program for the year 2024. I am a first generation doctor and I had no prior strong basis of the hierarchical system administratively of how a hospital works. Karachi wasn't my home station. I had to manage all the transport and the logistics on my own. Despite every hurdle, I still made it, and if I can, so can you. With a little faith and lots of effort, you can make it to the internship program of AGA, inshallah. Wishing you the very best of luck.